Hello and welcome. This is Gina Titcom. I'm joined by
Courtney Verhollen.
And we're here in Boston, Massachusetts. The All-Star Ultimate Tour will be taking on Boston Brute Squad. This is our last game of the All-Star Ultimate Tour. We're so excited to be here. It's been a really long journey. The team has come together so well, and we're excited to play against the defending national champions, Boston Brute Squad. So, Courtney, you play with Brute Squad, and I was wondering if you could give me a little bit more information about where they're at in their season and what they might be looking forward to.
Totally. First, I just want to say thank you for coming, and I think just like last year, especially this year, we're really excited to be your last stop, and I, really appreciate it. So, Brute Squad, we're doing well this year so far. we definitely want to take a look at last year and try to go as far as we did, but the reality, I think, for our team and what we try to remind ourselves is that every single game is the most important game. So right now, when we're trying to think about the season and where we want to go, right now what we're thinking about is this game today and to see what we can bring away from this game to our practice starting on Saturday and then gone from there. We've went to U.S. Open and started our, well, I guess that's actually, not actually, we went to Boston Invite first, started off very strong.
And won that tournament, if I recall.
Yeah, won that tournament. It's really fun to have a tournament at home and have a lot of people that are able to come out and see a lot of our local teams. And then we went to U.S. Open, which also quite thankfully very close here as well, and was able to walk away winning that tournament as well. And then just the last one, back in Colorado, a nice fight against your team, which was super fun, and a lovely rematch of the finals from last year. And as you know, and hopefully others, came out second, and just looking forward to 2 weekends from now for Pro Flight.
Yeah, sir. So for those of you that don't know, I play for Seattle Riot, so I've played against Brute Squad, and you know, really, if you're looking to watch a game where you see a team really attacking the weather and not letting the weather dictate an offensive set or a defensive set, watch the Brute Squad versus Riot U.S. Open Finals. And what you'll see there is Brute Squad does just a really good job of, like I said, attacking the wind, using it to their advantage, coming down with some great plays. I mean, the Cohen to Wong throw, if you haven't seen that one, check out YouTube. 70-yard huck from Shelly Cohen to Cassie Wong for a score. Should have been on SportsCenter, in my opinion.
I know. But we're biased, that's fine. But definitely should have been.
Yeah, and so, you know, Brute Squad is a phenomenal team, and there's a reason why they won the national championship last year. They're so much fun to watch, and they're really fearless. I love watching them play. So who are a couple players that we can look out for on Brute Squad tonight?
Yeah, I think what's really nice about Brute Squad is that we do have a very deep team, and every single person is involved on defense and in offense. For me personally, who I think is a fun one to watch is going to be number 52, Kaylin O'Connell. This is her first year with Brute Squad, and she just comes down with some phenomenal grabs and phenomenal plays. She can just get above most people that I know, which is amazing. And then another one who I really, really enjoy is number 5, Juliana Ruffelli. She came from Dartmouth, so nice local, just not too far from here. First year also on Brute Squad, was dominant on Dartmouth and is dominant on Brute Squad as well.
Yeah, nice D-line addition there. And I'm from Seattle, she's from Seattle, so I got to give a little bit of Seattle love there.
She does love Seattle, I will say. She really does.
Yeah. And then conversely, on the All-Stars, got a number of players to watch out for tonight. A player that I would like to highlight is number 21, Ellenelle Young. She's the youngest player on the All-Star Tour. She just finished her sophomore year at UBC. She's Canadian. Watch her leave her feet to get some Ds, and then watch how quickly she fakes in order to create windows in the throwing space. And then another person I'd like to have people be aware of is number 22, Sarah Edwards. She's a player from Seattle, played on University of Washington Element, currently plays on Seattle Underground. She's played on multiple multiple national teams, actually. Handler, cutter, she's really quite versatile. And watch her take some of the hardest matchups on Brute Squad. You'll see her really just work the entire game. And it's a thankless job. And she's fun to watch. Watch her footwork. Watch her make an impact on this game.
I mean, I feel like everyone is fun to watch on that All-Star team, though.
Yeah. I think we're biased, but
yeah.
Do you want to just give a couple of shout-outs? So just so that people know, there are a couple of players that will not be playing tonight for the All-Stars, and we'll keep you updated if any of that changes. Janina Freistadter, still suffering from a concussion injury, as well as Lindsay Sue, who is currently sidelined with an ankle injury. They both have actually warmed up just to sort of feel how those injuries kind of are feeling. And so if they decide to take the field, great. If not, that's why. And so just so that you know.
I was wondering, actually, well, I read some of the blogs that were up, and the one, and I'm sorry, I can't remember, it was Lindsay that talked about the injury blog.
Yeah.
I highly suggest everyone reads the blog. It's really fascinating to read everything that's going on the road from the All-Stars, but also I feel that every single player can relate to things that are said in that blog, and especially on the injury side too. It's very difficult to be on the sideline, but to be the best teammate and player that you can be, and see how you can add to the team. And I feel that what she was stating in that blog, especially on the All-Star tour, you know, it's such a small time, but that you can still be a phenomenal player and give exactly what you're giving, which was a great thing to read.
Yeah, absolutely. And for those of you that haven't seen it, check out allstarultimatetour.com and hit up the blog section. We have, I think, every single player has written a blog post. So check that out just for more insight on, you know, players' experiences, where they come from, what they're looking forward to, discussions that they want to have in the Ultimate community. All of those things can be found there. So for those of you that are just joining us, I'm Gina Titcomb, and I'm joined here by
Courtney Verhollen.
And we're here in Boston. We've got the All-Star Ultimate Tour taking on Boston Brute Squad. Brute Squad is wearing their blacks. It's their they love their blacks.
It's their,
and rightly so. They look great, and you know, we appreciate that. Up here in the booth, we can really see their numbers.
Yeah, it's definitely our number one choice every time, no matter what weather, no matter how hot it is. Those are good-looking jerseys.
Yeah, and the All-Stars are in yellow. And it looks like Brute Squad is starting this game on defense, and the All-Stars are starting on offense. And just a little bit of background for the All-Stars. They are playing essentially two pods. So both pods will play offense or defense. They'll play person defense. They'll play junk sets, whatever they're asked to do. So that gives just a little bit of insight of sort of their subbing system and how they have it all working out. So Brute Squad with a pull. We have Fitzgerald centering to Sprague. High release backhand over O'Connell to Revere. Revere looking for that deep shot. Holding now. Finding Fitzgerald. Forward to Ao Young, who attacks that disc nicely with Sadler right on her back. She goes out wide to Scarth. Back to Ao Young.
All-Stars are looking fast today, even it's been a long road.
And Revere airing it out to Schaffner. She cannot run that one out. So Angela Zhu picking up the disc. She's another player actually from Dartmouth on Brute Squad. So much fun to watch. She's played on multiple national teams as well. This is her third year playing for Brute Squad, I believe. An incredible player, and so young. She still has so many years ahead of her.
And so this duo right here, we have Angela Zhu, and then also we have number five, Raffaele. They work so well together in a handler set. And then you also have number 10, Sinicrope, as well. Those three are just a powerhouse in the back.
And Werfeli airing that out to Sadler. Revere poaches off her offender but cannot come up with a D. Back to Schwamm. And looking for O'Connor, who is open on that open side, but find Sinekrope and Schaffner with a near layout block. But Zoo is able to hold on. Zoo holding. Finding Sinekrope. Finds O'Connor for the score. That's exactly what you had mentioned. Somebody to look out for. And there she is, scoring the first break of the game.
And just so it's O'Connell. And no, it's all right. It's fair. It's, you know, she's so fast. How do we even know? and that's what Brew Squad it does do very well, is keep it nice and calm right at the end zone until they see that open shot.
That's a break to start out the game. And I know the All-Stars are a team that really play with a lot of pace. They like to move the disc quickly. And they also like to take a lot of, they like to take some deep shots and sort of live and die by it. But they've been pretty successful. And I know that really they're looking at those deep shots as a way to stay efficient, to have their offensive line or their offense in general just be efficient. With a small roster, efficiency is key. And I know that's one of their focuses going into this game.
Yeah, and how have they been feeling this whole... I mean, how are their bodies feeling just driving from coast to coast?
It's been pretty good. We had a day of driving yesterday. We played in D.C. against Scandal 2 days ago. Phenomenal game. If you haven't watched it, go back and watch it. And then drove all of yesterday and actually stayed with the Babbitt family right outside of Boston. And had a nice slow morning this morning and did some swimming, watched some Olympics last night. A lot of team bonding. That was great. So Walrus to Ogawa on the far side, back to Walrus, finding Miller. And this just slips out of her hands there. She's unable to hold on to that one. Sinekrope picking up the disc. Finding Dopkin. And a round throw to Zipperstein. A little too far out in front. Perhaps a miscommunication between the two of them. Donaldson to pick up the disc. A beautiful throw from Donaldson, looking for Kaler, who can't quite get a hand on it, but really Dopkin did a great job of reading that play, coming off of her defender. And Zipperstein boosts the backhand to Groom. That one is a little too far for her as well, so a couple turns apiece here.
So just as apparently the All-Stars also like to extend the field, as does Brute, really looking to try to put the disc a little further, be a little more efficient, but definitely taking some risks, especially early in the game. I think that where you're going to see a lot from Brute is his person defense. It's definitely what we try to focus on and have as our strongest defense.
Yeah, and we see that pressure right there. Donaldson looking for Zipperstein, or excuse me, looking for Kaler. I believe it was Sinekrope who was able to sort of jump the lane there on that low huck, and I think she might have gotten a piece of it. Not entirely sure, but Zipperstein picking up the disc, finding Dopkin on that undercut, and then forward to Sadler. Such a speedy player, so much fun to watch. Up to Groom. Brute Squad just working that open side undercut space around to Sadler, forward to Klain. Brute Squad really practically in the red zone at this point. Klain finding Sinekrope. Nice inside throw there from Sadler, finding Zipperstein. Looks like they have transitioned to their end zone. Sadler finding Groom for the score. Nice patient offense there from Brute Squad.
So something that I've seen that we've changed a little bit is typically we have Klain is usually a handler, and today it seems like she's cutting. So I think that there's going to be a little bit more of a variety than we would normally watch for Brute.
By the All-Stars to really keep Brute Squad 10, 15 yards out of the end zone. Brute Squad had to swing it back and forth twice, actually, before they were able to attack that end zone space. So that's good to see early on in the game, All-Stars putting pressure in that space. And then conversely, it's great to see Brute Squad, who's able to calmly just punch that in, take their time, swing the disc. So now's a good time to chat a little bit about the Boston Ultimate scene in general. So Boston, very well known for their multiple mixed teams that have a history of being so strong. What are some of the other women's teams that are here in Boston? Can you tell me a little bit more about that?
Yeah, so we have two well-known other women's teams that are Vice and Siege. Both teams that we absolutely love. We love supporting them. They love supporting us. When we had U.S. Open so close, Siege was there, and to be able to see them play against top teams and play very well.
Yeah, and they killed it. They took half on teams that were not expecting it, and they put up a lot of points on a number of teams.
Yeah, and I think specifically for Siege, this is their second year, and to see how strong that they can come out this year already so early in their team life right now was absolutely wonderful to see. And they just keep on doing really well. I think they were at Chesapeake, I want to say. Is that there, or was it Heavyweights?
I'm not sure.
All these tournaments, so many names. But also, just a strong, strong team that I'm really excited about for their future to come here. And when we had tryouts, all the teams from mixed and women's all got together, bringing in as many players as we could, and we had a massive turnout, and which also turned into, it was somewhere around 80 people to their tryouts, which is
just
fantastic.
Speaks to the growth of women's Ultimate in Boston, and really the demand, right? Those are 80 players that want to play women's Ultimate. It's great to see.
Definitely.
So back to the action here. We have the All-Stars on offense. Fitzgerald, nice break around to Revere. Was able to haul that one in. And this matchup, the Schaffner-Bitterman matchup, will be so interesting. Two players that are so well known for their speed, and also just their nose for the end zone. I imagine it'll be fun. So Schaffner up to Revere. And an around to Fitzgerald. Sort of waits that one out. Break to Revere. Some nice break throws here. Revere boosts a forehand looking for Scarth. Can she run it out? And unfortunately she cannot. It's a little bit too far in front.
I imagine it has to be so hard to line up across from this All-Star team and decide who wants to take who. Every single matchup just seems that it's just going to push it to your limits.
So we've got Tajima picking up the disc. She's got Zhu and Werfeli there in that handler set. Tajima usually plays on the O-line, so it's interesting to see that Brute Squad has sort of pulled her onto this defensive line to secure another break. Holding an inside break. Gets D'd by Sue, who's able to just read that beautifully. And it looks like Sue is having no trouble with that ankle because she just got a block. Fitzgerald looking for Edwards. She's clearing out. And the speedster Ao Young gets free up the line. Back to Fitzgerald. And a nice throw to Schaffner. Who hangs on, back to Fitzgerald, acting truly as every other.
Their patience in this red zone is fantastic right now.
Great a round break from Fitzgerald to Edwards, faking, fakes the lefty, and then looking for Schaffner instead. And Schaffner cannot hang on. Just to note, before this game, it has really been pouring on and off. So not only is the disc probably a little slick still, the turf is also quite slippery.
This is definitely a mirror image of last year's game as well, raining until game time.
And now there used to be some sun, so we're a little confused by this weather, Boston. But we're happy to play, you know, rain or shine. These are athletes that, you know, don't take weather into account. They only control what they can control. Klain turnover there, but Ao Young really did get a nice hand on that. All-Stars get their possession back. Schaffner back to Revere holding high stall count here. And she finds Edwards right in front of the end zone. A lot of double cutting here from the All-Stars.
The All-Stars have really put on fantastic dump defense and fantastic handler defense in general. That's keeping the disc right in their end zone.
And this bodes well for really an exciting game down the stretch. If it's so hard for each team to score right now, they're only going to be able to game plan each other as the game evolves. So looks like the All-Stars will take a timeout. And just so you know, we've got we love this venue. It's actually quite close to a metro stop. But if you hear a train passing by, it actually is because the orange line is directly behind the stands. So if you hear some thundering, it's the train. Not a scary monster coming to get you.
It's funny, I was curious how long it was going to take me to talk about the T in public transportation in Boston, how wonderful it is, and the fact that you can jump out right here to come watch us play, everybody.
Yeah, and here's the T right here. You see it passes right above the stands. Nice and loud.
Orange line, almost as good as the red line, just saying.
So the All-Stars will be on offense here. I think they had a little bit of double cutting there at the front of the stack. So it'll be nice for them to be able to take a timeout, sort of settle down, and determine, okay, I'm cutting and you're holding, or I'm clearing and you're filling. That'll be critical for them to get this hold here. So we have Edwards with the disc. Tajima on the mark, doing a nice job of flexing. And she's able to find Schaffner, 2 yards in front of her, who beats her defender to that space. And you'll see Schaffner actually giving us an interesting spike. So for those of you that don't know the movie Stick It, it is a movie about gymnastics and the paradigm of men watching female athletes and men judging female sports. And so you'll see here, Schaffner's going to pull out her bra strap and flip it and then give a clap and a little shout out. And that's just kind of a reminder that, hey, we're here to compete and to be ourselves, and we don't really care how people judge us.
So trivia about Stick It, someone on Brute Squad, that's their favorite film.
What?
Who on Brute Squad is that? You can tweet at us.
Okay.
Well,
honestly,
I
would say...
Oh, no.
I would say Bitterman, but I know that her favorite movie is Hoops, Loving Basketball.
Loving Hoops? Man, we gotta get you some film knowledge here. Loving Hoops, let's do it.
Got a little bit of crap for that one. I played on Brute Squad a couple years ago. But so I almost think that it's could be Bitterman. Anyways, back to the action here. We've got Tennell picking up the disc. This is Brute Squad's true offensive line, finding Hoffman underneath in that isolated side stack. Forward to Bitterman. And then to Tennell. Bitterman is with a nice swim move to get open. Out to Cohen. Now Brute Squad in their end zone set, finding Tennell. And then looking for Malinowski, and we have a way bidding, but can't quite get a hand on that. Here's that there is a pick. So I believe it'll stay back with Malinowski, who finds Tennell. Tennell is going to attack this end zone with a beautiful inside flick. She's got 3 Brute Squad players, but unfortunately just a little too far in front out of each of them. But a beautiful throw, really, and a nice space to attack. So All-Stars will have a shot here to break. We've got Walrus picking up the disc. Breaking around to Donaldson, and Dobkin leaving her feet to make a play. A little bit of contact there with Donaldson, but they're all smiles.
So we're all smiles.
This will get tapped back in. Donaldson around to Kaler. looking for Odie, and she's able to track this one down. She's got Cohen on her back, but she bodies her out really nicely in order to maintain that possession. Odie back to Donaldson. Then again to Odie. What I really love about the All-Stars is that they're a team that is so versatile that they often have players that cycle in and out of handling and cutting positions. And they can do that because, as we see, Donaldson put a flick huck up, but Bitterman reads that nicely. They can do that because they're players that have been in both positions and are familiar with that. And a fantastic grab from Hoffman on a flick huck from Tennell. And Tennell is streaking down. She's not able to get that one in bounds, but she maintains possession right in the middle of that end zone line. And Malinowski to Cohen, who hauls that one in for the score.
Yeah, so what you were mentioning before with how versatile that team, All-Star team, is, it is really hard to play any sort of defense on that when you just don't know what you're marking up against.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think it allows the All-Stars to cut deep and cut under, in a way that makes them so dangerous. And you can't force them under, because then they'll get the disc and sort of beat you with their throws, and you can't force them deep because they're incredibly threatening in the air. So sort of pick your poison, and that's why I think they're a team that are really fun to watch and learn from. So Brute Squad there with a hold. They'll take off their O-line, put on their D-line once again. We have the All-Stars on offense. France, Fitzgerald, Sprague, Schaffner, Edwards, Revere, and Scarth.
So saying that all of these players are such strong players on their teams, how has that played a role for figuring out what their roles are on the All-Star team?
I think it's been players figuring out that, hey, I'm going to buy into the system no matter what it is, and I'm happy to play whatever role is needed of me. And, you know, we're going to figure that out together, whatever my role is. And we see that, you know, in every single play, essentially. Revere up to Sprague, who airs out a forehand, looking for Scarth, and Groom able to make that play. That throw is just a little bit too low, and so Groom is able to make that play.
It's tough. It's tough to go deep with Groom on you. She's
it's tough to go anywhere with Groom on you, really. She's true. So fast and so good in the air. So much fun to watch. So we have Zipperstein picking up the disc, finding Sinekrope. Holding in the middle of the field. Up to Groom. Groom launching a forehand to Sadler. We have Schaffner in coverage. She's able to get that block back for her team.
This is also a fun matchup we had when we had Bitterman before, but now here we have Sadler.
Schaffner up to Revere. Wide to France. Back to Revere. Nice grab there. Zippy throw from France. Revere finding Fitzgerald. She holsters that backhand. I actually thought that she had thrown it. Nice mark from Sinekrope to really just force so much yardage loss for the All-Stars. France to Sprague. Expect to see an inside flick here from her. She's so well known for that. Revere.
It's like you know the future.
To Schaffner. I've been watching these players quite a bit, turns out. Schaffner around to Fitzgerald. Can she run it out? Yes, she can. She's able to maintain possession. She hits the turf. Back to Schaffner. The All-Stars in their end zone set. We'll see if they can maintain this patience. I know it's something that they're working on. And Fitzgerald didn't know that Schaffner was perhaps clearing there, but Schaffner is able to hold on. And a soft, high-release break backhand to Scarth. It's a nice hold for the All-Stars. We'll see this one again. We'll see Fitzgerald load up a backhand. And Schaffner isn't quite anticipating that throw is going to come up, but she has the wherewithal to get her hands on it. And a nice, soft, high-release backhand. She's going to find Scarth right in the front there. Mm. So I'm seeing via Twitter that we do have a couple fans here from Stick It. And I love that Stick It fans all over the world are enthused by our discussion. But I think it's something that's really been coming up with the All-Stars this trip because the Olympics are happening. And there have been a lot of interesting conversations and interesting articles out there about the coverage of the women in the Olympics and the female athletes and how they're being talked about and how they're being showcased. And I don't know, it seems fitting that that's that sort of display, specifically talking about gymnastics, which is a sport that has such phenomenal athletes, so strong. And people often get caught up in what they look like. And it's frustrating.
Yeah, it's very frustrating. And then also, what's interesting, though, is that when you, even with gymnastics, if we were watching, if anyone was watching last night, you really can have people of different sizes and strengths doing a sport like that. And all that matters is that they're doing that sport. Mm-hmm. That's what we're needed, what we're trying to focus on. And also just how much media is to that right now, but how many people are tuning in to watch that, and it's only every 4 years. Why is that? Mm-hmm. When there's so many people that want to watch specifically women's gymnastics.
Yeah, it's a whole nother discussion. Tanel up to Cook, finding Malinowski on that under, forward to Bitterman, to Dopkin, and Brute Squad just marching down this field right now. And nice back in there from Dopkin, finding Malinowski. I like how she sort of sizes up Malinowski and throws that nice and early before Malinowski is really committed to that deep cut. Or sorry, that away cut, I should say.
Regarding with Dopkin, as you see here, she is... You're going to see her all over the place. She plays on Brute's O-line. She plays on Brute's D-line. She is expected to... be everything, and that's what she's showing this year, and hopefully she won't stop.
So this is her second year on Brute Squad, I believe.
Yes, this is her second year, and for me personally, watching Dokken this year has been amazing. Her confidence on this field this year has been something that's inspiring. To come out onto the field and be the player that needs to be on both lines and show up and change your mental game in a second. That's what she wanted to do and is willing to do and is and doing every game.
So Brute Squad does have a couple of rookies this year, right?
We do.
So I know that last year there were definitely a number, and this year there's a couple less, but they are notable. And, you know, they're rookies, but it's funny. I don't even consider them rookies because of how much experience they have, right? So we mentioned Caitlin O'Connell, number 52, Juliana Werfeli, number 5. Who else? Kim.
Yeah, so
Kim Culpin.
Kim Culpin,
who's not here tonight, but another rookie.
Allie Heath was playing on Wild Card, and now we have her. Mm-hmm. We also have Molly, who is back. Molly Hallweaver. She wasn't here last year, but she's here now, but not today, but on the team this year.
Yeah, so a lot of, you know, rookies, but phenomenal rookies. And we have Kaler boosting that one, looking for Way, a nice target for the All-Stars. And three Brute Squad defenders really peel off and cover a lot of ground to make that throw just, you know, a turnover. So we have Zhu picking up the disc.
So again, this is an unfair pair here in the handling of Zhu and Raffelli. Just have all year together, all the time.
Zhu to Schwamm, and a nice switch there from the All-Star defenders. Schwamm looking for Zhu up the line, but an unfortunate miscommunication. It sort of goes a little bit behind Zhu, actually. Miller picking it up, finding Odie, open in that space. Swinging to Donaldson. I like this O'Connell-Donaldson match. It's a lot of limbs there and a lot of height. Donaldson for Kaler. Nice loopy forehand to that space. And then forward to Way for the All-Star hold.
Yeah, we have a few people on the team that have just limbs for days. You know, absolutely limbs for days.
A lot of great height on Brute Squad for sure. I mean, Becky Malinowski is one. Lula Tanel. that's also quite tall. I think you don't see it as much because she's a handler, and so sometimes people don't think that she's quite that big. But, you know, when she cuts deep and she skies you, that's when you know that she's pretty tall. So the All-Stars here on defense shot out a break. We'll see if they're able to get a turnover from this Brute Squad O-line. It's really an O-line that is known for sustained excellence. I mean, they execute a side stack better than anyone, I think, in the division. And when they're taken out of it, they still find creative ways to move the disc and open up different options.
Definitely. I think that it's a lot of these people have actually, a lot of these players have had experience together before Brute Squad, which was really helpful in that. Even just having Lila Tanel and Shelley Coleman has been a wonderful pair because they play in North Carolina together.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so those are two players that both went to UNC and
yes.
then both played on Phoenix. But was it called Phoenix at that point?
I think so.
Okay.
Ooh, I think
Ooh.
So. Ooh, can someone correct us if we're wrong?
Yeah, tweet us at AllStarUlti and at 100% BS. Those Twitter handles are right there. We have Bitterman with the disc, forward to Malinowski. Edwards draws that matchup. Back to Bitterman with Ao Young. Two speedy players as well. And a flick to Hoffman. No problem for her. Brute Squad score so effectively and so efficiently.
And so this year, this is with Brute Squad. I know that was from Laura Bitterman up to Hoffman, but what's been strong on this O-line is having Leanne Hoffman and Lila Tanel, who both played at Worlds together, and having that pair of playing with another team to bring back more talent and more information to bring back to Brute Squad is just making that O-line even stronger.
So Brute Squad here with their defensive line, we've got Groom, Sipperstein, Sinicrope, Tajima, Schwamm, O'Connell, and Negus. I think it'll be really interesting. I mean, we've seen Sinicrope sort of take the center offensive handler for the All-Stars, and she's just been so deadly on that mark. She does an excellent job of knowing when to sort of squeeze on that around and punishing the All-Stars for wanting to go and swing the disc. So Zipperstein with a great pull. We'll have France bringing it down and centering to Fitzgerald. Spoke too soon. She finds Revere under. Back to Fitzgerald. Then to France. Inside break to Schaffner. And then Ao Young. Revere and Groom almost nearly gets a block on that throw, but Revere does hang on. Up to Fitzgerald. Schaffner. The All-Stars sort of in a transition here, but looks like they are still staying in their horizontal set. A lot of handlers in that dump space, but Ao Young connects with Fitzgerald. Nice clear there by Sprague that opens up that around throw to Revere. And Revere finding Schaffner and then France.
That was a great cut by Schaffner. Just getting Groom off of her shoulder a little bit and just that being that wide open throw.
We'll see this one again. We have Fitzgerald to Revere. And Revere hits this around and Schaffner does a nice job of tracking it. Sprague also in the area. She finds France. So the score is now 5-4 if you're just joining us. The All-Stars are in yellow and Brute Squad is in black. And we did get a little bit of help from Twitter. Turns out that Lila was actually one of the co-founders of Phoenix.
Great.
And she played on both Backhoe and Phoenix. But Shelley Cohen played only on Phoenix. So thanks, Heather and Brower, for giving us a little bit of history there. Glad to add that information to the broadcast. I mean, we want everyone out there to know sort of the history of these players and where they come from. And how that influences how they play and who they are. And just, you know, players that you know where they come from and that you know their story, it's a lot easier to buy into Women's Ultimate. And I think that part of the problem there is that there's not as much media coverage in a lot of sports, and I think Ultimate is similar in that way, is that, you know, if you don't know the story of a team, it's really hard to become a fan of that team and to follow them throughout their season. So All-Stars here pulling. We've got Brute Squad. Tanel holding the disc, finding Bitterman underneath. Bitterman looking for Malinowski. Way chasing. Malinowski to Cohen. The All-Stars appear to have a forced middle set here. Bitterman to Dopkin. Back to Cook. Finding Tanel. Brute Squad in their end zone set. Tanel around to Cook. I knew that inside flick was coming from Cook. She's got such a speedy release on that.
Yeah, if I could even cut off half the time on my release of my flick to get closer to Cook, I would do that in a heartbeat. She's been around for a long time and has been very strong for Brute Squad for years.
Walrus to Sue. Nice to see her on the field tonight. Back to Walrus, finding Kaler. Forward to Wei, who actually had changed directions, but is able to make that happen. Kaler to Walrus, forward to Sue. He's generating a lot of yards underneath. Sue around to Walrus. Another nice around to Donaldson. Doing a nice job of using that lateral movement, that lateral space. Walrus, Sue. A little bit of stagnation here from the All-Stars. Downfield cutters.
Yeah, I think that Brute Squad's trying to answer back with how many hucks have been coming off with a straight-up mark.
Kaler. Back to Donaldson. The All-Stars are slowly but surely moving backwards, struggling to find upfield yardage gainage. That's not English, but... Kaler. Back to Donaldson. Back to Kaler. All-Stars sort of just standing downfield. Rifling an inside throw to Miller. And that's just the amount of pressure that Brute Squad's O-line can put on a team on defense. And that's pretty incredible. Tanel ripping a forehand to Bitterman. And that's no problem. Tanel is excited about that. She's celebrating with her teammates. She's got two hands up. Power position. I love it.
This is tough. That O-line is a very fast O-line to try to keep up with Laura Bitterman and Leanne Hoffman. And if that fast break is off, it's difficult to shut them down.
So Brute Squad is up 6-4. Sorry. And we'll see the defensive Brute Squad line take the field once again. And the All-Stars looking for a hold. So on offense here for the All-Stars, we have Sprague, Scarth, Revere, Ao Young, Schaffner. She actually has her back turned to us, so I can't quite see Fitzgerald. And there's one more player. There we go. Edwards.
Has the All-Star teams been playing O-line, D-lines at all, or is it just you're going out there? I know you're saying with pods.
Yeah, so they've switched up a little bit. At first they had players who were mostly playing O, players mostly playing D, and then having specific defensive sets, sort of, that they could throw out there, different looks. I think they've had to adjust that for a couple reasons. One of them is just simply injuries, sort of had to change those lines, and then I think they've decided they like to want to use their versatility and just become even more dangerous. Schaffner to Revere, underneath to Edwards. The All-Stars moving the disc nicely. Finding Ao Young. Edwards clearing up line. Ao Young looking for Scarth. Looks like McLean bids but is unable to come up with it. Scarth holds on and finds Schaffner in the end zone. What a nice throw from Scarth.
Same area as that Brute Squad goal. Nice quick up the line. Nice flick. Going deep.
Yeah. So see Scarth sort of regain her footage after that clean bid, but she gets up and she sees that Schaffner just takes one step in and then fakes, is able to make her defender turn her hips. And that's no small feat, because actually Lauren Sadler is the one that's guarding her.
That's hard for anybody. Sadler came from Seattle. Thank you for her. We appreciate her a lot.
Yeah, so for those of you that don't know, Lauren Sadler played in D.C. for a number of years, won a couple of national championships there, played on Seattle Riot last year, and this is her rookie year on Brute Squad. And she is a player that I think you can learn a lot from in terms of her handler defense. And she's not a player that, you know, that's not all she does, don't get me wrong. But she is probably the best at that single thing. And that makes her just so important to a team, and she can generate so many blocks just guarding defenders.
Definitely. And she's quick, and you don't expect her, and all of a sudden she's just coming out of nowhere. I see Cassie Wong warming up on the sideline, who I was not expecting to play today. So we might see her today.
All-Stars with the D. With a pull, excuse me. Tanel to Dopkin. Finding Malinowski. The All-Stars in a junk set here. Back to Tanel. Nice loopy forehand to Hoffman. And then finding Dopkin. Nice backhand looking for Malinowski. And she's able to come down with that one. She had Donaldson and Kaler, who are not small players, but she does a good job of picking her head up and realizing that it's coming her way.
Yeah, there's Dopkin again, just showing up on the O-line, and then knowing that Malinowski is just a player who can bring the majority of discs down from the air. She's definitely a tough one in the air. And again, another player that was on the Mixed Worlds team that we're so lucky is back with us.
Yeah, and she also played Beach Worlds the year before. She graduated from Michigan, mm-hmm. I believe. And she's a player that is so dangerous deep, but is also so dangerous with the disc. You can't force her under because she's going to come and distribute the disc beautifully. She's got excellent deep shots. She's got excellent break throws. And then you can't force her out because she's tall. And not only is she tall, she knows how to use it. She bodies up really well, boxes out, and then she can just jump so high.
Definitely.
So timeout here. And I'm not exactly sure who took that timeout, but the Brute Squad is up 7-5. The All-Stars will have a chance here to hold as Brute Squad's defensive line takes the field. Like you said, looks like Cassie Wong is here. She's number 71, and she's a player to watch out for. Last year was her first year on Brute Squad. She came from Bent, I believe.
Yeah, phenomenal player on Bent. She captained the team there, and we're very appreciative of getting her from last year. She's always been a strong player on Bent. She was very well known in this area of the United States, I guess.
The women's division in general, I would say.
Definitely. She's just a phenomenal, phenomenal player. And then to add her talent and her speed and her power onto the field with the handlers that we have that are looking to throw to someone that will really just run deep into that end zone, she's just been a wonderful add and going to be huge this year for us as well.
Yeah, and I've seen her just get even more and more comfortable on the field with Brute Squad, finding out what space to attack and, finding out what throws to throw and where her receivers are going to be. It's Fitzgerald to Sprague, back to Fitzgerald, around to France. France finding the Scarth. Scarth draws that Wong matchup. We've got Edwards Nice break around to France. Finding Revere. And then Sprague. Forward to Fitzgerald, who gets a hand on that and is able to hang on. Here's that nice mark from Sinicrope. You'll see she starts at 45, and actually she adjusts her mark about 2 stall counts in to go more no round and squeezing that sideline.
As you were talking about with Sadler before, Sinicrope is also just a phenomenal mark on handlers, and that's her strong point as well.
France around to Edwards, who elevates above Wong. Back to Fitzgerald. Edwards. Looking for Scarth, and Groom just gets a hand on that one. Groom going deep. She's got Scarth on her. Schwamm forward to Zhu, and unfortunately those two cannot connect. Edwards finding Fitzgerald. Back to Edwards. And then to Ao Young. I think the challenge here with the All-Stars is that because they're so versatile, what sometimes happens, so you have too many players coming into the handler space or too many players coming in, staying in the cutter space.
Definitely. But what they can see, what they've been doing really well at is hitting the players even though the pressure is on from the Bruce Squad defense. They're not nervous or scared of it one bit.
And Fitzgerald to France, who really gets a nice hand on that despite it being a low throw, and then forward to Revere. We'll get another chance to look at this one here. Well, Fitzgerald, you'll see France, she's gonna cut to that inside lane. We'll see Sinicrope actually adjust her mark to go more, parallel. And Fitzgerald, or excuse me, France, finding Revere, that front cone. This is a tight game, folks. Brute Squad is up, 7-6. This is for half for Brute Squad.
It seems like the All-Stars have taken down a little bit from the risk-taking and just trying to move it forward and swinging it back and forth between their handlers, which I think has actually done really well for them. I think maybe taking those chances and trying to beat someone like Melonowski or Groom in the air has been a little bit more difficult. So them moving the field, or the disc down the field, has been extremely helpful for them, especially in this last point.
Yeah, and we've got fans online who are also noticing Sinicrope's excellent defense, and then also giving some props to Claire Revere, who, is just constantly open under. She does a great job of setting up her cuts, not just running the space that she's trying to get the disc in, but being dangerous at multiple different angles. Tajima to Cook. All-Stars in the junk set here, trying to slow down the Brute Squad offense. To Tennell. Malinowski in that deep space. She's a fun target. Cook around to Hoffman. The All-Stars appear to have transitioned to their person defense here. Hoffman to Cook. And on... looking for Dobkin, and Sue is able to get a hand on that. That's an incredibly hard D to get.
That was
so impressive. Walrus looking for Odie on the around. Nice mark by Tennell, forcing that loss of 15 yards. Odie back to Walrus, forward to Odie, but Bitterman reads that really well. And she also goes for that disc so early that there's no chance of a dangerous play. No one's going to get hurt in that situation. And Malinowski attempts the greatest there. I didn't think she was that close to the line, but she knows best. The All-Stars are going to have another shot here at a break. Donaldson to Sue. Back to Donaldson. A little bit of collision downfield, but the players are happy to keep playing. Walrus around to Donaldson. Nice loopy backhand from Donaldson, finding Kaler, and Kaler boosts a backhand to Ogawa. Can she run it out?
So close.
Another miscue from the All-Stars, and that's actually one, at least the third huck that we've seen that's just been a little too far out in front.
Can we just talk about both those Ds? Just such good heads-up defense by both teams. I think that's that's what we're looking for right now. It's just strong, hard defense.
Tajima, looks like the All-Stars are still in their junk set from the beginning of this point. Tanel, beautiful loopy forehand to Dopkin, and she cannot get a hand on that. She likes to go for the one-handed grab, and it slips through her hand. So the All-Stars, another shot at a break. This is one of those times that you might look back on. Huge forehand, Donaldson looking for Wei, and that's a connection. Wei holding on, finding Odie. Odie with a nice around to Sue, and a beautiful break from the All-Stars makes it 7-7. And what a nice way that, you know, Sue got that first D and really put Brute Squad on their heels. It's so nice to see her rewarded with that score. So see Odie, it's a nice loopy forehand here to Sue. So what I was saying before, you kind of look at these moments and you think of them as potential momentum shifts. And maybe when you're playing in the game, you might not be able to see that happen or maybe feel that. But, you know, Brute Squad going up 8-6 is much different than a break to make it sevens. And then, you know, there's a little bit less confidence perhaps for the Brute Squad offense. Are they going to be able to hold? They weren't able to hold the last point.
Yeah, I completely agree. And that's, I think, where, at least on the mental side, that I hope every team takes, and definitely one that we try to remember and teach ourselves, is that every single point is the 0-0 game to 1. And this idea of momentum is something that one of our coaches isn't the biggest fan of, because what that is just an energy that you're feeling and the intention that you have. But if you are just focusing on that point right there, and that is the only thing that matters right now, then all you can do is try to hit your potential then. But now here we are, 7-7, and this is exciting because whoever will take this one will take half.
Great. And, you know, it's really interesting we say that, but, you know, these are athletes that have, you know how to react under pressure and know how to react when maybe something doesn't go their way. So, I'm not expecting Brute Squad to step down from this challenge. We have Zoo up to Cinegrope. It's currently unguarded. Back to Zoo. Not sure if that was intentional. Zoo up to Cinegrope. Happy to just pass it between the two of them. Inside to Groom. Groom, Scarth on the mark. And Groom breaks that around to Cinegrope, all the way to Zoo, an inside flick to Schwamm, a nice throw there. Schwamm faking, finding Zoo, clearing out of that space, and Zoo finds Wong for the score and to take half. And just like, Brute Squad is a team that does not shy away from that pressure. And they were able to just work that down the field. Not a single pass looked hurried or rushed.
Definitely, and I think the reality is that it's the All-Stars are putting on the pressure, and which is fantastic, and we've seen already great Ds, and they're going to keep coming. And I'm glad that, yeah, Brute can walk down and be confident, but it is showing to be an awesome game tonight.
So Brute Squad takes half here, 8-7. I'm Sheena Titcomb. I've been joined by
Courtney Verhollen.
Thanks so much for being with us. Hope to catch you in the second half. We're going to take a short break and be back.
Hey, you guys have anything to do with the lights? Okay, good. Because I'd say it's probably about... We have 10 minutes.
Hello and welcome. This is Chyna Titcomb, and I'm joined here by
Jesse Durrett.
And we're here at the All-Star Ultimate Tour versus DC Scandal Showcase game. This is our second to last game of the tour. Next up, we'll be playing Boston Fruit Squad.
And it goes inside and then out to the end zone.
And a phenomenal layout block from Jenny Wei. Taylor, nice shot to Ogawa, who's able to hold on. Marcus finds Faye, who unleashes a backhand. Faye with a crossfield backhand, and Scarth just undercuts that inside throw. Holding the disc, finding Ao Young, who just elevates and lays out into the end zone. Push her under, except as soon as I said that, Radcliffe airs one out to Faye, Odie's in the area, and Faye just calls that one in. Shocker. He's Revere downfield and boosts a backhand. Revere is great in the air. I like that.
Quick turn.
Walrus sending Ogawa, who dumps to Donaldson. Donaldson rips a forehand looking for Wei. Another great connection with the second huck we've seen from Donaldson to Wei. Wow, another forehand huck looking for Wei. Is this going to work? And it does. Wei rips that pass to the Scandal defenders. That's another break for the All-Stars.
That was definitely a crowd pleaser. And it works.
Scoover over the top to Taylor. And Ito with a phenomenal cut. But Wei chopping on that mark, but so much length to Jorgensen. Walrus to Odie, who boosts a forehand to Ogawa. Jorgensen, and the crowd just erupts. Jorgensen unleashes to Faye. Donaldson, nice backhand break, finding Kaler. Kaler looking for Donaldson.
Great put.
France, Irely backhand, finding Revere. Ito unleashes a forehand to Faye. See the crowd here. Things are getting thrown out into the crowd, and the crowd is going crazy. Boone and France bidding. Streaks up line, and Grunwald looking for Markowski. Up to, wow, Kowalski.
And there were three defenders.
And a flick looking for Pate.
Wow, two big throws.
Huge hammer. Garvey reading it. And she's able to get a hand on that. Step on Julia. And a huge slick cup to who else is standing Jorgensen. That's a great throw from Grunwald.
I can't believe that's the game. I want them to keep playing.
Thank you. Hello and welcome back. This is Gina Titcom. I'm joined by
Courtney Verhollen.
And we're here at the Brute Squad versus All-Star Ultimate Tour. Brute Squad is up 8-7. And we've got a fan there who's running around with the All-Star sign. It's actually one of the crew members on board, Exton Titcom, my brother. He is sporting actually a brand new haircut today. We had a couple of minutes before the game, and he showed the hairdresser the Schaffner bun and said, hey, I want this. So that's what you've got, the Schaffner bun, also known as a man bun.
All the buns.
Stevie Miller fondly dubbed it the Schaffner bun.
Oh, all right. I like that.
He's got a star on the back of his head there, repping the All-Stars. So during this halftime, you saw our highlight clip from the All-Star versus DC Scandal game. And just want to let you know, we have a lot of videos just like that, a lot of great content on the All-Star Facebook. You can check out All-Star Ultimate Tour, as well as our website, allstarultimatetour.com. And then if you aren't following us via Twitter, I'm not sure why you wouldn't be, because that's where everything is happening. And we've got a lot of great clips there as well. So check out those different mediums to find more awesome media of female athletes and women in Ultimate.
So one of the things that we, a lot of us coach on Brute Squad, and one of the things that is very valuable is watching high-level Ultimate. So I would highly suggest for anyone that is coaching also to really take a look at these videos just to see how movement is on the field. It's been very helpful for us.
Yeah, creating more media of female athletes and making that accessible to anybody free of charge is one of the missions of the All-Star Ultimate Tour. We're excited to be doing that. Do want to give out a shout out to our partners, Five Ultimate. That's the awesome uniforms that you see the All-Stars sporting. The shorts as well as Daywalkers are actually online for sale on the Five Ultimate online store, so check that out. We're also happy to be working with Ulti Photos that take some nice shots of our games, make us look good. Cliff Bar, Eric, early recognition is critical. And then, of course, Fulcrum Media. This would not be happening without the phenomenal Luke Johnson, as well as our camera operator, Eddie Chan. And then we have another camera operator, Dana, with us tonight. So thank you to all those people that make this happen.
I think Brute Squad is excited to get this game moving. Been on the line waiting to receive the poll. Maybe because the lights came on. Not quite sure. But
yeah, it's a nice experience, I think, playing in a stadium and playing under the lights. For a lot of Ultimate players, you know, you play during the day. You play at tournaments. And you might play in stadiums, but very seldomly do you play under the lights. So it's kind of a cool feeling out there for the players to experience. So Brute Squad here on offense, and they're currently up 8-7. Schaffner on the pole. Brute Squad has got a pretty typical offensive line. We've got Cohen, Dobkin, Tajima, Hoffman, Tanel, Bitterman, and Malinowski. If you hear any kind of thundering in the background, it is because the T is just passing by us right now. There's a subway line right behind the stands, so you can see it at the top of your screen there. We apologize, but we also love it. It makes it easier for fans to get here to the stadium. Tanel with a disc in the middle of the field. Hoffman isolated in space. Up to Malinowski. Around to Cohen. Around to Tanel. Revere drawing that Tanel matchup. Finding Dobkin. Back to Tanel. Forward to Dobkin. Nice one-handed snag there. A little bit behind her, but she's able to hang on. Back to Tajima. Tanel. The All-Stars doing a good job of slowing down the Brute Squad offense. Getting them a little bit out of their rhythm. But Tanel finding Hoffman on a really nice trademark inside flick. Fake from Tanel to a high release backhand. If you watch Tanel play, she loves that sequence, and she's so deadly with it. Hoffman to Tennell to Bitterman. Looking for Tennell. Nice break around from Bitterman. Here we'll see a nice break from Tennell. So deadly with the disc. And Hoffman finds Malinowski for that score. Just beats her defender and beats her mark there.
And so another thing that you can watch again with this, our end zone offense, is that we really are isolating that one person who is looking for that disc. And everyone else is patient, waiting to basically what their turn is. And that's why it was such an easy find for Hoffman to Malinowski for the score. And now...
Well, Brute Squad on defense. And we've actually got quite an energetic crowd there. We've got some fun gifts to throw out to them. Some All-Star Ultimate Tour branded merch. And the fans are excited to be there. We've got some announcers on that far side who are sort of giving information to the crowd about, you know, what the All-Star Ultimate Tour is and who Brute Squad is and why this game matters and why this tour is important for our community. So the All-Stars are going to be on offense here. It's getting a little bit harder to see. Just so you guys know, we're up here in the press box. So the lights from this angle sometimes make it hard, but... We've got Walrus, Ogawa, Donaldson, Odie, Way, Sue, and Miller on this offensive line. Miller up to Walrus. Way underneath. Nice defense from Negus in the lane, covering Odie's multiple cuts. Way resets to Walrus. Stall count rising, but she finds Sue. Sue faking, looking for an option. Boosts it to who else but her Phoenix teammate, Jenny Way. Jenny Way right in front of the end zone line. Looking for Donaldson, who bobbles, but who's actually able to focus and, you know, get her hand on that second attempt. Miller. High release backhand to Donaldson. Was able to maintain possession. And then a high release flick to Sue. Right in that space. Beautiful shot from Donaldson. A nice break throw from Miller to set it all up.
Yeah, Brute Squad has been doing a good job taking away the rounds, but those high release backhands, those are tough to stop.
And I think that Donaldson gets that disc because she's just a couple inches taller than Cinecrope, and Cinecrope was right there. And another thing to think about is that kind of pressure just builds over the course of a game, and Cinecrope is within inches. She'll get the next D, I have no doubt about that. So the Brute Squad is up 9-8. For those of you that are just joining us, All-Stars are in yellow and Brute Squad is in black. It's a tight game. It's been so much fun to watch. We've got a really great crowd out in front of us.
So for people who don't know, you had one season on Brute Squad?
Yeah, I played with Brute Squad in 2014. Mm-hmm. Is that correct? Yes, 2014.
We missed each other.
Yes.
Eventually, one year.
Yeah, Brute Squad, such a phenomenal team. I really loved playing with them, and now I play for Seattle Riot, but I feel like I've learned a lot from Brute Squad and a number of players on that team. Made me feel so welcomed when I came on the team. I was just a junior, going to my senior year of college. Really great experience. Cook up to Tajima, back to Cook. Tajima. Nice clear there from Cook to create that space for Malinowski, who finds Hoffman, then to Bitterman. Quick give-go movement to Malinowski, and looks like it'll be a foul call. Malinowski had her forehand grip in there, and Fitzgerald just knocks the disc out of her hands, but no contest. Come back in with Malinowski. Bitterman to Tajima, a round break to Hoffman. Thinks about the backhand break, finds Tajima in the middle of the field instead. Forward to Malinowski. And the speed of Bitterman Elinow Young, who's marking up on her, is not slow. I'll tell you that much. But Bitterman is so fast.
Yeah, one of the things that, well, Bitterman brings a lot of things to the O-line, but one of the things that Bitterman brings, other than just speed, is that the second she gets that disc, she wants to put that disc in someone else's hand so she can get it back again. It doesn't really stay in her hands long, which really helps that Brute Squad offense move quickly down the field.
So Brute Squad will be on defensive here. And, you know, it's interesting. We haven't really seen many defensive sets necessarily from Brute Squad. And I think that's partially because Brute Squad is a team that's so well known for their person defense. So well known for being in their offender's pocket and not letting any throw be an easy one.
Definitely. And I think what you were talking about before regarding weather with Seattle Riot's game against Brute Squad, that doesn't really affect both teams. I will say that Brute Squad will put on zone even when weather is around and finds that person defense is really always what they're going to fall back on.
Huge pull here from Brute Squad. Miller going to be centering to Walrus. Donaldson isolated in space. So deadly as a initiating cutter. Up to Kaler. Eating up yards there on that far sideline. Kaler around to Miller, who's tracking it down. High release to Donaldson. And a break backhand huck from Donaldson. Fortunately, it was not on the same page as her cutter, Jenny Way, who changed directions to actually come under to the open side.
Those high release backhands, though, from the All-Stars, just destroying Brute Squad's defense right now.
And I think that's a throw that works right now. It's just so you guys know, it's actually not that windy out. It's pretty calm. And that's a throw that works really well when the weather is going your way. Zhu up to Groom. Fakes off Wong in the lane. Goes around to Zhu. Looking for Schwamm, who elevates for that catch. Forward to Zipperstein. Nice break back in for Zipperstein to Zhu. Raffelli. Brute Squad in a horizontal step, but only two handlers back. Wong to Groom. A nice forehand huck from Groom, but Way reads that and is able to get under it. I actually like that throw from Groom, though, because it's a nice bladey flick, and it goes over Groom's defender. Way just does an excellent job of reading the disc.
Definitely. That was a fantastic D. Very heads up.
Way boosting one of her own, looking for Walrus. And Wong and Werfeli are there to make sure that that doesn't happen. Werfeli to Groom. To Zhu. Looking for Schwamm. And Miller's able to undercut that throw. Come up with a block. Kaler to Walrus, who finds Way. Her defender had attempted to get a poach block. Way found herself open in the end zone.
Yeah, I think the All-Stars are doing a fantastic job to just keeping their heads up and taking advantage of any opportunity that comes to them on defense right now.
Yeah, Walrus, really sneaky throw from Kaler, but Walrus is able to haul that in between two players and then hits Way, no problem. She does a good job of actually throwing to Way away from the defenders and away from anywhere else really that a defender could come and intercept that pass. Getting a nice shot of the sky here in Boston. It was so rainy and so gross earlier, but it's turned into a beautiful night for Ultimate.
I'm happy that we got the crowd that we got and no one was too afraid of that rain.
Yeah, we posted in the Facebook event, said, hey, rain or shine, we're going to play, so bring your ponchos, bring your umbrellas. This is going to happen. And it's great to see a crowd that isn't deterred by that. So we have All-Stars on defense. We have Ao Young, France, Scarth, Schaffner, Edwards, Fitzgerald, and Sprague. Brute Squad on O, Cohen, centering to Tajima. No Tunnel on this line. Cohen forward to Hoffman. Back to Cohen. Finding Cook. Malinowski. Back to Tajima. And an excellent cut from Bitterman. She essentially does a triple cut and makes Ao Young choose how to guard her, and she's able to get free under. Cohen forward to Hoffman. Hoffman looking for Tajima, and she's able to find her in that front cone. Nice strike cut from Tajima.
So I think just as All-Stars are very similar in this, Bruce Squad has also been putting some of their handlers again downfield. Shelly Cohen finding herself in a cutting position, which makes her extremely dangerous because once that disc is in her hands, she has every throw. And that's very similar on the All-Star side, and it's fun to watch players be so dynamic in every way.
So Brute Squad here on D. We've got Werfelli, Sadler, Klain, Cinecrope, O'Connell, Zipperstein, and Wong. That's a fierce defensive line. You know, looking, you know, if I was the All-Stars right now, looking across the line at that squad, they've got speed, they've got skill, they've got the athleticism. And they've got a high Frisbee IQ. That's a line that has a lot of experience playing high-level women's ultimate. And, you know, high-level mixed ultimate as well. Crowd is going crazy as Miller centers the disc to Walrus. Looking for Donaldson. Finding Miller instead. Walrus. Forward to Kaler. Bruce Squad does a nice job of shutting down that side stack of the All-Stars. Kaler back to Walrus. And Odie. Miller and Sadler so close on that. And a nice move by Odie gets free up line and boosts the forehand looking for Kaler. Wong reads that, and that shot's just a little too far out in front for Kaler.
That was a great cut just to put herself in that power position.
Yeah, she wanted to take advantage of the work that she put in to get open. So I want to see Brute Squad here in a vertical stack. We haven't seen this from them yet. Cinecrope finding Sadler underneath the Wong, and she cannot quite hold on to that one. Walrus picking up immediately. A little bit of Oregon offense in her, wanting to get the disc moving as quick as possible. And Ogawa. It's like there's a pick called, but also, oh. Ogawa. Out to Odie. Inside flick to Kaler, and a soft around backhand to Miller. And the All-Stars put that one in. It's now 11-10.
We really have a great game on our hands here.
We'll get to see this one again. A nice inside throw from Odie and Kaler, who's able to find Miller. And that's kind of one of the downsides of sort of squeezing on the mark, is that you leave that inside lane open. And just a nice job by Odie to recognize that, find her teammate on the inside, which then opens up the entire other half of the field, you know, through Kaler's backhand to Miller right there.
Yeah, sometimes making that inside flick look a little bit nicer is what Bruce Squad is trying to do, but when you have those throws, anything is dangerous.
Yeah. So this is a really close game here. Just to let you guys know, we are playing game to 15. We've communicated that with the observers and both teams, unlike last year where there was a little bit of confusion as to what we were playing to.
I feel like that happened this year as well.
Well, a couple of moments, yeah. A little bit of confusion, but so we're playing to 15. Soft cap is at 8:40, and hard cap is at 8:50. So that's just about 20 minutes from now is when soft cap will go off. Revere with the pull, Cook up to Tunnel, junk set from the All-Stars, trying to slow down Brute Squad, resetting to Cook. Nice flick to Hoffman, wide to Malinowski, who will often actually find herself in the handler set during these defensive junks. Malinowski finding Bitterman. Schaffner within near D in the lane. Hoffman finding Cook. And Cook forward to Bitterman. And Revere reads the play nicely. He's able to come up with that block.
Again, All-Stars coming up with this heads-up defense that has just been so strong all night.
Sprague to Ao Young, finding Scarth. And Edwards is free downfield, but she's unable to find her. But she does find Schaffner for a really nice gainer and goes the full 40 yards all the way to Edwards. Edwards holding inside to Schaffner, who leaves her feet to make that catch. Soft around backhand to Scarth, and a miscommunication there. Scarth had already changed directions to come to the open side. Tennell picking up the disc and ripping a backhand to Malinowski. And that's something that if you play Brute Squad, you got to know that they like to look for. Malinowski to Hoffman. All-Stars do a nice job of sort of recovering there, but Hoffman is able to find Malinowski for a nice hold from Brute Squad.
That was just an absolute fantastic D by Schaffner. Just wonderful, but the second that Brute Squad can have a fast break, they will take advantage of it the second they can.
So I heard a little rumor, and I'm not sure if this is true, but is Leila Tennell the record winner for Nutsy Camp distance? Someone tweeted that at us.
I feel like that's true, but that's just because Leila is fantastic and can play or can throw really far. So that's because I can assume that as being correct. Now, is it? I'm not sure, but just watching her play is enough evidence for me.
I'm sure somebody, if we're wrong, which, you know, I think we're right, will let us know via Twitter. So tweet at us at AllStarLT and at 100% BS. Tina Booth, if you're listening,
yeah,
you probably have that information. But if I'm not mistaken, she's actually here at the game. Love having, a persona in Ultimate really here at the game. Love seeing her here.
One fact about Leila, though, that I do know is that she works at Brookfield Farms, and she is our farmer. And that is one wonderful thing about Leila that she loves to be and we love her for, is all the vegetables she gives us.
Walrus up to Miller. Back to Walrus. Forward to Kaler. Kaler boosting a forehand to Donaldson. Usually it's the other way around, but beautiful shot from Kaler. Donaldson just needs to run that one out and get her hands on it, and she does.
It seems that both teams, and especially the All-Stars, opening up their game once again, taking those shots. So, you know, if you just have just a few steps, like in this play here, just nice deep shot into the end zone. And it makes it fun for the fans.
Yeah, and that's... I like that Kaler throws that nice and early. For those of you that don't know, the 25 tips by the All-Star Ultimate Tour, you can download it on our Facebook page as well as on Ulti Results. One of the things that Kaler says is throw early. And you see her really exemplifying that. She's able to throw that because she throws early. Donaldson isn't already in that deep space. So the All-Stars are down 11-12 in a really close match. On this defensive line, we've got Walrus, Miller, Kaler, Odie, Ogawa, Way, and Donaldson. You know, we haven't talked much about Ogawa this game, but she's a player that has a lot of experience playing on international teams. She's played on the under-23 Japanese national team that won gold in London last year, and then she also just recently played with the Japanese women's team again in London this year. She's got a nose for the end zone and has very sticky fingers. She comes down with so much for the All-Stars. Tennell ripping a backhand to Malinowski. And that one is no problem. There's that really long backhand from Tennell.
Yeah, there's the argument for you, right? I mean,
we'll see this one again as Malinowski just rips that down. And Donaldson just doesn't have a shot. It's such a perfect throw. And that's how Tennell is deadly. She doesn't put Malinowski in a position where she has to make a play.
Yeah, it's very true. I mean, it's again, some of these throws that you can see from Tennell can be looked that they possibly could be difficult, but the reality is that she has every throw. And you know that as the cutter, and Malinowski knows that as the cutter. So Malinowski can just get the speed. She knows to expect the disc.
Wonder if the All-Stars will force backhand once again. We shall see. The All-Stars on offense here. We've got France, Young, Revere, Scarth, Edwards, Fitzgerald, and Schaffner. Just to remind you guys, it is a game to 15. Brute Squad is currently up 13 to 11. They have a soft cap in about 15 minutes or 16 minutes, and then hard cap 10 minutes after that. But Fitzgerald forward to Ao Young. Fakes the low backhand to Revere, but finding Fitzgerald instead. Out to Schaffner. And then to Scarth. Scarth forward to Kaler, and Schaffner booking it for the end zone right now. She actually draws two defenders, which allows for France, I believe, to hit her. And then Fitzgerald wide to Scarth. Inside flick to Edwards, and a beautiful shot from Kate Scarth. The All-Stars really needing that energy. You have all the players running onto the field, running around, trying to build momentum for themselves here.
And again, the All-Stars are taking advantage of that inside, Scarth, that inside flick, just all day that Brute has been giving away a little bit.
Yeah, nice run there from Edwards. And it does appear that was Claire France. Claire France and Bethany Kaler are both wearing blue headbands, so I apologize for mixing them up this past point. So this is the last stop on the All-Star Ultimate Tour, but we're really hoping that this is really just the stepping stone for what else can come for women in Ultimate, and to hope that people will build upon this momentum. I think we've seen from last year's tour and from this year's tour that people are really excited about Women's Ultimate and want to support it. It's just figuring out how to do that and what the best way is to do that.
Yeah, I know that Brute Squad definitely appreciates the viewpoint of Women's Ultimate and bringing media here and being able to show everyone how great it can be and phenomenal players that are throughout the United States. And I hope this can keep going as long as it can.
Good. Brute Squad on offense here. That pole goes out of bounds, but Claudia Tajima will be picking that one up. Special shout out to her from me. She was my captain at Tufts my freshman and sophomore year. Played with her on Brute Squad and also on the beach national team. She's a phenomenal player, phenomenal leader. She'll make you look silly on the field with her throws, but is all smiles on the sideline. Cook, nice pressure here from the All-Stars, pushing Brute Squad further and further back. Tajima to Bitterman, forward to Tennell, sneaks it through the outreached arms of Donaldson. Cook, back to Tajima. Smart switching here from the All-Stars. Groom, a nice break backhand to Tennell, who boosts a huge backhand. We've got Way in that deep space, Schwamm as well, and Bitterman does a phenomenal job of following the play. And as a teammate, you've got to be thankful there. We'll see this one again. Tennell sizes her up and unleashes a backhand. Wade does a great job of getting in front of, I believe that's Schramm, and trying to get a hand on that disc. And you'll see Bitterman on the far side there, just running with the play and making that catch.
I mean, Schwamm was definitely in a space that she knew that she had hard coverage, so she wanted to try to get that disc, but Bitterman just picking up that trash.
I think that's something that we can learn from Bitterman, is she's a player that's really smart, not just with her cutting, but the way that she sees space and cuts with her teammates. She doesn't just cut for herself. She cuts to make space for her teammates, and she cuts to help her teammates.
Definitely. Definitely.
Great crowd here. They're excited for Frisbees. We love the announcers that are helping us keep the crowd engaged and cheering for both teams. Nice to see people excited about Women's Ultimate.
So this is game point for Brute Squad, and this is definitely a way that they love to try to end games on defense. So we'll see Brute Squad coming out strong.
Do want to give a shout out to our observers here that are helping us keep track of time and have an extra set of eyes on the game. We've got Greg Connolly and Kate Elliott. Thank you for donating your time. Walrus. High stall count. She's boosting it, looking for Odie. And Werfeli just gets a hand on that one.
That was a great mark by Negus, making sure that that round backhand wasn't coming to come off, and Werfeli was ready.
Yeah, she knew that the stall count was rising, and she was able to read that play really well and get a hand on that disc. Cinecro picking up a round backhand to Sadler. Back to Cinecro. Cinecro-Au Young matchup is really fun. Two very speedy players. Sadler up to O'Connell. Now Wong. Finding Negus. And Cinecrope with a beautiful swim move there to get open. And Cinecrope boosts the backhand, looking for O'Connell, who maintains possession, going over her defender to make that play.
Yeah, and that's what we love to see from O'Connell. That's what O'Connell adds to this Brute Squad line, that D line, but also just what adds to Brute Squad in the end zone. Gets up huge. We'd like to thank Slow White for that one. We appreciate that very much.
Yeah, she gets her hands on that. And then, you know what I really like here is that Cinecrope does a good job of reading what Au Young is providing her. And so Au Young sort of overcommits on that forehand, and it opens up that backhand for a nice break backhand hook.
Definitely.
And that's game. Brute Squad takes it 15-12. Know that All-Stars have a lot of emotions right now. This is their last stop of this tour. They've got to be proud of this game. Phenomenal display of athleticism and skill. And really a true game, going back and forth and back and forth, and game plan and adjustments. So thanks so much for joining us. I'm Chyna Titcomb. I've been joined by
Courtney Verhollen.
Keep supporting Women in Ultimate. And thanks for joining us. Good night.
Good night.